Welcome to this presentation of the COGNITWIN Toolbox portal, demonstrator of the portal itself. My name is Arne Berre. I'm the technical coordinator of the COGNITWIN project from SINTEF. I'll start with providing a background on the setup that we have for the toolbox. And the foundation for this is basically how we in the COGNITWIN project have a structured our approach to cognitive plants supported by cognitive twins, and how we are building that up from a digital twin, or a set of digital twins rather, both first order and data-driven twins, combining those in hybrid twins, and then adding cognitive aspects for this. The way we have structured our setup and toolbox, we have aligned with various reference models. In particular here, we see to the right the BDBA reference model, the Big Data Value Association for big data, and showing various technology areas here that we are covering tools and components for. In the middle, we see what we call the Big Data and AI pipeline, that has been derived from work in BDVA and also from a project called DataBench that have identified the life cycle setup from data acquisition to data preparation, analytics, machine learning, and visualization. This is also mapped to the emerging European AI data and robotics framework, which has defined also areas that are related to this. We see some of the arrows representing this. So we can view this both from an AI and from a big data perspective. In our context with a set of twins, we basically have looked at these four steps and the data flow, merging that into our conceptual perspective, identifying then the data acquisition and collection for digital twins, data representation of digital twins, the analytics, which are where we are extending also with hybrid twins, combining various digital twin modeling with first order models, data-driven models, also cognitive models, and digital twin visualization and also control and access to the environment. So these are the way we kind of structured our building of pipelines, and we have reflected that in the toolbox. We see the elements here, and we see how we on top are following those four steps. And then underneath here, we see the various tools and components and methods that we are using in each of those steps with their subcategories. Further, we have a number of components in red here, which have been developed and are maintained and further used in the COGNITWIN project by the partners, but also those in black, which are open source tools or market tools that are part of the overall pipeline for the realization we have in the project with six different pilots and also other variations on this. So I'll now switch to show the demonstrator itself of the platform portal. Just pointing out the context here that we will see for each of the components in red, we have their descriptions as we see below here with information, further details, licensing and setup. Typically, the toolbox is then used to select various components and bring them into a configuration for usage. One example is seen here, done by the Technopar partner and Noxel for the Noxel pilot, where a number of components in each of those areas have been selected and are connecting together to provide the support for that particular situation. So I'll now switch over to show the tool itself. So now this is the portal, what you see here, the COGNITWIN Toolbox portal. So basically this is a web-based application where all of these components are found and are structured according to the model I just shown. So we have on the left here a number of sensor types, IoT telemetry sensors, but also cameras, RGB, infrared, laser cameras. I'm not showing those here. We have separate activities on selection of these, but start to show how we are then getting data, collecting data from this with OPC UA interfaces and a number of servers. Also how we connect things with orchestration, how we have front-end support for AI at the edge, and underlying connections of this in platforms, also methodologies that goes across there. As we go over to the digital twin representation, we have support for storage and event processing, digital twin representations and data spaces. And further, as we are adding modeling to this for the hybrid cognitive analytics models, we have first order models and machine learning models and a combination of those. And then finally, visualization and also interaction and control with environment. So the portal essentially contain information about all of these tools, and I'll go through some examples. We have separate demonstrators of a number of tools and configurations that you can find on the YouTube COGNITWIN channel. So I will just show now the principle of how to navigate this in the portal. Starting with the digital twin data acquisition and collection on the communication part, where OPC, both UA and DA is one of the foundations we have. And start to look at Cybernetica OPC UA server. We can select that and we get further information about this. So then it described in detail kind of the structure of that tool. We also have references to the context here. So we have here in this particular situation, we have the Cybernetica tool set, which we can also look at there. Let's see here, which is the context of the model predictive control environment that we'll find later for the hybrid models. And that describes also in the context of where this particular OPC UA is being used. So we have that situation for all of this. Look also here at the Fuse OPC UA, which is when we get into the Fuse modeling that we will see later for the modeling. There are a link here into data transfer that is used in that context. This is from the University of Oulu partner, and we have further information on the links as we find here. So we'll do that. So for some of these, we also have connections into yeah, there are different pages here. Actually, for Cybernetica, we have a link directly to this homepage on that front end. And then we see the licenses, copyright licenses or open source licenses of various kinds. Going back to this, we see that besides the various OPC tools, we also have orchestration with stream pipes. And we have some adapters for this here. Like the stream pipes adapters that has been done in this context from Technopar, using a setup where when new sources and syncs are connected, so like NoSQL database Cassandra or the Fiverr Orion context broker has been linked in with the stream pipe adapter setup. So there is a set of different tools here. Maybe I can show also that for the stream pipe adapter we had here. We also have a link, I think, as we go down here to stream pipes, which is the setup that we are using. Maybe I'll show that here. That's the stream pipes environment that we have also linked to in the tool reference. And this is used as one of the, say, external tools to connect various of the components to each other, which we have also separate demonstrators of. So let me then continue from the digital twin data acquisition and tools you have on the left here to the stream that we have on image analytics and also front-end with FPGA support for at the edge handling of images. This is from the Scortex partner, where we have a frame grabber FPGA compute platform to essentially do AI at the edge machine learning inference. So there is a component here for the frame grabber. And further on, we have a component also for the edge inference itself, where the need for high speed means that it's feasible here to do the inference at the edge itself. And this is what the Scortex components put together is providing. So this was for the parts of the data acquisition. We also have some connections of this in terms of platforms. So the Bedrock platform basically describe a set of these components put together with OPC UA servers. This is kind of the whole pipeline, as we'll see elements of later, with links to analytics, data storage, and visualization. And similar, we have this draws from SINTEF. We have also from Technopar, their Industrial Internet of Things platform, which is providing a setup of a number of these elements and pipelines where these are connected together. So the components are not only in isolation, they are put together in various configurations, as we see, both in full platforms and also in the practical pilots, as we have separate demonstrators of. So continuing then to the next phase of digital twin representation. Particularly, we have chosen to use the Industry 4.0 AIS, which is the asset administration shell, as a strategy for how to represent digital twin interfaces and APIs. We have a separate paper where we evaluated a number of those and concluded on this. So looking at that here, we see the Fraunhofer AIS tool description. And there is a separate demonstrator of this also that can be seen. So then the setup for the AIS is described here. It's further also linked into to connection to other tools. So we have here the Streampipes event processing processor, which describes also how we do complex event processing with Streampipes. And then there are demonstrators of how these things are linked together. So basically, the platform setup allows us to create various implementations, and we have examples of that, as well as pipelines. So this is the kind of IoT aspect. It's also important with image analytics, and we have started also to look into use of image analytics and machine learnings in various situations. Here is a component on aerial photogrammetry, which is used in particular in the use case we have with SARS-DAL, how to analyze and understand what the camera is seeing with the analysis of, in particular here, where we look at the identification on steel billets. So this is a component that deals with understanding 3D models from the environment, which is a core component in that particular pipeline for image analytics. So this is from the FKI. Also mentioned that we have a methodology perspective. So the methodology on pragmatism in physics-based modeling is basically a method and a way of thinking for physical and physics-based mathematical models throughout the whole pipeline. So this is a method component. If you go up and see that in our setup, we see that we have some methods also, which talks about a way of thinking and also links to tools that can be used, but basically is a methodology. And we have also some other methodology aspects that will be relevant. Okay, so then we have looked at the digital twin representation, just some examples. There are many tools here. The purpose here is not to go through all of these. There are separate demonstrators for a number of those. But continuing now to the digital twin analytics. So we are looking at the models, and we have machine learning models and the data-driven models, and we have also first-order models. So we can look at the Steel machine learning library that we have from Technopar here, basically applying a number of machine learning algorithms to data in the context of predicting maintenance applications with associated the libraries and analysis of this, which can be found here. And then besides the machine learning, we also have the image analytics, and we have some technologies on that. So basically for image analytics, particular machine learning libraries for deep learning on images, which is connected to the FPGA we looked at earlier from Scortex. And we also have the Neuroscope Visual Debugger for Convolutional Neural Networks from DFKI, which again has been applied and used in the context of the SARSTAL pilot we have for analysis of identification of steel billets here. So there's a number of tools that can also be applied in other contexts for machine learning. And then we have also the first order models, where we have a set of models in the FUSE setup from University of Oulu, which look at process input and state estimation for physical model predictions in say various physical processes. Here applied in the Sumitomo case in particular, but also can be applied in other situations. So that's this modeling tool with some associated tools. And we also have the Cybernetica Zenit tool set, which we looked a little bit at earlier, but that was the OPC part. Now we have the other parts of the modeling here, for a model predictive, nonlinear model predictive control, and also the ongoing work on the cognitive CNIT, which is the further extension of this tool now for doing more automatic self-diagnosing and combining things with machine learning and AI. So some of these components are in development, and for all of them, we have the access and the licenses and the setup. There is a number of other components here. They are covered in other demonstrators. Going back to the last step here with visualization and control services, we have various tools for interaction with the twins. Visualization here from the Technopar tool that is supporting both 3D and 2D models of the digital twins. And we also similarly have for the Cybernetica models here, viewers, and way to create visualization and inspections of the various models that are being done in that context. So the purpose of this was basically to show that all of these components are structured and grouped in various ways and can be combined in various ways. Not everything can be combined with everything, of course. So we have different pipelines that are set up for this, and we are demonstrating that in 6 different pilot cases, and also have generic pipelines on this, using some tools like stream pipes to connect and ease the connection also between components. Otherwise, also, there are well-defined interfaces on the tools. That is the basis. So for that, there are separate demonstrators that we encourage you to look at. So thank you very much. And please take a look at some of the other related demonstrators also. Thank you.